Hi, today I'm gonna show you features of FEVR on multimodal imaging. So let's get going. This fundus picture of the right eye shows retinal exudation at the posterior pole and along the arcades. In the temporal periphery, avascular retina is present, and at the junction of vascular and avascular retina, venous-venous looping is seen. Also to be seen are telangiectatic bulb-like endings. This patient has been following up with us for a long time, and laser marks can be seen in the temporal, superior and inferior quadrants. The left eye has subtle findings and a temporal splitting of retinal blood vessel can be noted. Also present in the temporal periphery are the laser marks. This little girl is a diagnosed case of FEVR and has been visiting us for a few years now. Wide field FFA is of special significance in FEVR. Let's have a look at the girl's FFA on her first visit. The temporal periphery shows abnormal vasculature with capillary non-perfusion areas. An avascular area is very evident in the temporal periphery with staining of venous-venous vascular loops and some leakage of dye from telangiectatic bulb-like endings. While the right eye shows florid leakage from abnormal vasculature present mainly in the temporal quadrant and also in the superior and inferior quadrant. FFA highlights the peripheral avascular area in the early stage of the disease when other signs are very subtle, and the presence of CNP areas demands laser photocoagulation. FFA should be repeated on follow-up visits to look for the presence of new CNP areas. We found this new CNP area on follow-up visit of this little girl, and this area was subsequently lasered. On OCT, macular edema is seen as increased central macular thickness along with distorted foveal contour and hyperreflective inner layers. The intraretinal exudates appear hyperreflective with intense back shadowing. Eyes with only peripheral retinal involvement may have a normal macula. FEVR is a rare pediatric hereditary disorder that involves incomplete vascularization of the peripheral retina, with autosomal dominant being the most common mode of inheritance. Genes NDP, FZD4, LRP5, and TSPEN12 are known to be responsible for FEVR. Peripheral avascular retina leads to near vascularization, which causes vessel straightening, macular dragging, and retinal detachment. FEVR is a bilateral asymmetric disease of the eyes, which affects both the sexes, and the child may be asymptomatic or may have diminution of vision. Nystagmus or exotropia. The peripheral avascular areas may be present 360 degrees but are more prominent in the temporal quadrant. Retinopathy of prematurity is the first differential of FEVR, but kids with FEVR are born full term and have a normal birth weight with no history of perinatal complications or supplemental oxygen therapy. Coats disease affects mostly males and is unilateral without traction. Nori disease presents with mental retardation and hearing loss. The treatment involves laser photocoagulation to the peripheral avascular areas, while anti-VEGF injections reduce exudation and neovascularization. Retinal detachment usually requires sparse plana vitrectomy with or without scleral buckling. Early management of FEVR improves the quality of life of the child, and successful treatment of every child saves several fruitful years of vision. I hope you enjoyed the presentation. See you soon. Bye and stay safe.
I spy